main thesis I try to respond in this book is to what extent it can exist a unilateral right to secession, in particularly in democratic context. The point, the argument I try to defend in the book is that in a case such as Catalonia, it must follow, it must at least three requirements. The first one is the democratic dimension, that is, the movement must be of democratic expression, inclusive, based on civic values, and so on. The second element has to do with a communitarian dimension, and particularly the fact that it must be a long-lasting movement of self-government demands. And the third one deals with the efforts to channel these self-determination demands using the existing constitutional framework. This last point is particularly important as it involves the state response to these self-government demands. We could say that this last criteria puts the burden of proof also on the state's side, as long as these demands, if expressed democratically, are being expressed by a part of their own citizenry. So the state cannot take a position where it simply rejects to channel these democratic demands. Rather, to the contrary, it has to offer the possibility for a democratic expression of these constitutional preferences. In the absence of this scenario, this would open the possibility for a unilateral process of secession, that is, to exercise external self-determination without the consent of the state. In the field of federalist studies, we cannot say there are uncontroversial findings or undiscussed elements that always work in every context. What we can reasonably say is that recognizing diversity can strengthen rather than weaken the polity. That is, recognizing diversity improves the viability of the polity. In the second place, we could say that it is always better to give an early and general and generous response to self-government demands rather to wait until this is a process or a situation with high levels of conflict. In this sense, we could say that will is always better than imposition in the last place. The more involved in the process are the constituent units of the nation, the better prospects for viability. And lastly, that the idea of federalism as such is not enough. That is, we must introduce other sort of democratic practices, such as consociational issues or power sharing agreements, respect and different sorts of rights to protect and promote diversity within the state to make these sort of multi-ethnic federations viable.